gonna start off with a big bowl. And we're gonna split this between some raw kale and spinach. So just for nutrition facts, salad is loaded with folic acid, a lot of vitamins, but especially calcium, which the bones need. So if you're doing a vegan version of this salad or vegetarian, feel comforted in knowing that you're getting a lot of calcium from your spinach. The other thing that we're using for our green leafy vegetable is kale. And kale is loaded with vitamin A, vitamin C, and also a lot of protein, believe it or not. So in the morning when James makes his shakes, he uses the kale to add some protein in there instead of the traditional protein powder. But we're just gonna dig into this. This is pre-washed, but I'm gonna just take a little bit of sea salt and sprinkle this into my leaves so that they have flavor in every bite. And it's not really a lot, just about that much, okay? Sprinkle that in. Okay, and then a little bit of black pepper will also bring out some flavor when people take bite. And I think that's enough for me and hubby. He is gonna love this salad. Ladies, don't be afraid to serve your man salad. If he's coming home from a long day and looking to have some lunch, you want to give him something light so you can, you know, have a fun afternoon. So I'm just going to mix these greens and get some of that salt and pepper on my leaves. And I hear my chicken sizzling. It'll be time to flip that over soon. And I just had that cooking on a grill, just some grilled chicken to go on top of here. All right, that's mixed nice and pretty. I love that. Okay, next we're going to get this onion. And I just have about half of a small red onion. We're just going to chop that pepper down real fast. Watch your fingers. It doesn't have to be all crazy, you know. I just want these, you know, big chunky pieces in here. Because I like long pieces of onion in my salad. I don't like the little diced look. So I think it just gives the salad a little more texture, makes it that much more beautiful. So you do it how you like. If you want to go ahead and, you know, like the middle piece and chop that up, that's fine. No problem. Like I always say, recipes are made to be changed and made to your liking. You know, there's nothing wrong with that. A little bit more onion in here. Okay. Just kind of move those around a little bit. Next up, you know what? I think I'll do my yellow pepper here first. And it's so pretty and full of color. I just love these. I love the way that they look. Make sure you get the sticker off. But I love the way that they look. I love the way it brightens up the salad. It's like a little bit of sunshine in there, you know? And the one thing that James likes is nice, presentable food. So I always try to make sure that my food looks really pretty on the plate. Because if it looks good, he knows it's gonna taste good. And that's a little trick for you too. If you're ever worried about the flavor of your food, and you're like, I don't know if it's going to be good. Listen, just make it look really pretty. And somewhere in the mind, I'm not a psychology major, but somewhere in the mind, that food just tastes that much better because someone took the time to make it pretty. Next up, we have our blueberries. We're going to layer that blue against the yellow, a little bit of contrast. Something I learned from HGTV, right? Okay, so we're going to take these blueberries and layer them in. And this just adds a nice, you know, that blueberry, that tart but yet sweet flavor. It's, you know, adding some texture to your salad, making it nice and pretty. I love that. I love the flavor of blueberries. I used to hate them when I was a little girl. But my, you know, my taste buds have changed since I've gotten older. I actually enjoy the flavor of different foods. So I just took about a half of a carton there. You don't want to overwhelm your salad. All right, we're just gonna take some strawberries and take off the tops, the hats, and we'll just throw those in there. And these are nice and juicy. And I always use organic fruits and vegetable, guys, with the exception of like the hard shelled fruits or vegetables. So for example, like watermelon, I don't necessarily think they have to be organic because the pesticides don't penetrate. I do give them a good rinse though before I serve them to my loved ones. But they're not GMO yet, so I think we're okay. There you go, and that's rainbow salad. I'll get a little bit closer to you. Look how pretty this salad is. Would you not just go crazy to see this on your plate looking that delicious and beautiful? All right, so there you go. And all you have to do is just serve this on the plate, chop up your grilled chicken, place it on top, serve it with watermelon dressing if it's really refreshing and crisp. And then that's a really great, delicious lunch to serve to someone you love. All right, I have to finish getting the plate ready for James. I hope that you have a great day. Leave your comment below on this page and let me know what you think of the rainbow salad. And if there's another cool salad that you like to make, share it with me. I'd love to see your recipes. All right, from my kitchen to yours, have an awesome day. Bye, guys.